In this video, I will explain the asynchronous copy process of your Aleratec USB HDD copy tower SA duplicator. After selecting the copy area settings, systems, and files as explained in part 2 of this series, ensure the asynchronous mode is enabled in the setup menu. Note, if your source data exceeds the amount of the system buffer, which is 256 megabytes, or use the whole media copy area setting in the setup menu, you cannot use the asynchronous copy mode. Use the arrow buttons to navigate to one copy, and you should see data in parentheses. Insert your source and target USB drives into their respective ports. Press the OK button, and the copying process will begin. The duplicator will compare the source data size to the system buffer. The LED indicator lights will begin flashing when the copying process starts. The LCD screen will display pass, fail, and copy counters. When you see a solid green LED on a specific port, this means that specific drive has finished copying. At this point, you may remove that drive and insert another target drive to be copied. You will see the count of drives that have passed or failed increase as you insert more drives, while the copy count decreases as drives are copied. When a copy process is complete, the copy counter will read 0 and will display a count of how many drives have passed or failed. To determine if a specific drive has passed or failed, use your arrow buttons to cycle through specific drive port numbers, starting with number 2, which is target port 1. The display will show each drive port number that has passed or failed by displaying pass or failed. The LED indicator lights on each drive port will display a solid green light for passed drives and a solid red light for failed drives. To copy additional USB drives, press Escape, remove the drives that have copied, insert more target drives, and press OK. Press the Escape button when you are finished copying to return to the main menu.